Hello all, and welcome back to this very special episode of What's What. Today, we are going to examine the principles of magnetism and experiment with the construction of an electromagnet. So get those working fingers ready, because we are about to explore. Before we get started, don't forget to like and subscribe. Yes, did you see it? Electromagnetism. This paperclip was moved and attached to my magnet. But how do we turn this into this? What is electromagnetism? To answer that, we'll take a look at the functions of an electromagnet. But to truly understand how it works, we must first break down the principles of magnetism. Magnetism is a phenomenon in which objects attract or repel certain materials. We know that matter is made of atoms, and atoms are made of moving protons and electrons. In most materials, atoms consist of electrons that spin in different directions. But in a magnet, electrons spin in the same direction. Only a few materials have this property. Iron, cobalt, and nickel, for example. Rocks, minerals, and alloys also contain a density of elements that make them magnetized. Magnetized objects have two poles, north and south. The lines of a magnetic field flow into the south pole and expel from the north pole. If we take two magnets, like these, and match the north and south poles, an attractive force pulls them together. Wow! Now, inversely, if the same poles are facing each other, the repelling force makes it near impossible to push the magnets together. Here we go! That is a lot of force. Science remains unbeatable. Once again. Magnets are made up of solid material and have permanent properties. But an electric circuit with a conductive coil can also act as an intermittent magnet depending on its current flow. This is called an electromagnet, where current flows through a wire and creates a magnetic field around the wire itself, due to Ampere's law. The direction of the magnetic field it produces follows something known as the right-hand rule, which is actually quite easy to understand. If we take our right hand and wrap it around an object, with our pinky at the bottom or south, and thumb at the top or north, the shape of our fingers represents the direction of the magnetic field, and our thumb here shows us the direction of the current. When a wire is coiled tighter with more turns and closer together, the electromagnet becomes stronger or more efficient. This is because the magnetism is passing through the center of the coil and creates a field around it, thus superimposing its strength to the neighboring coils. The coil forming the shape of a straight tube is called a solenoid. With its coils and iron core, it pushes a magnetic field from its south to north poles. And guess what? This is the exact type of electromagnet we are going to build today. To create our electromagnet, we will need copper insulated wire, a battery, tape, a screw, plier, and wire cutters. Remember to be careful with your cutters. Okay, let's get into the build. If we recall that the number of coils correlates to the strength of our electromagnet, we know that the more rotations we do, the better. Let's take our copper wire and wrap it around our screw. Make sure that the coils are nice and snug and try to make as many rotations as possible. Now we have to cut the wire, but we want to be sure to leave enough space to connect the wire to the battery. About 8 to 10 cm should be fine. Then we'll use pliers to bend each end of the coil into small loops, which will act as our connectors to the battery. Once that is done, we connect each loop to the opposite ends of the battery. Electrical tape can be applied to the negative side. And for the positive side, we'll adjust our wire so it fits around the battery. And there you have it, a complete electromagnet. Here comes the moment of truth to test our work. Look at that! It worked! I'm usually not so lucky. So we see that every step is important. If you don't get it right the first time, no problem. Just make some small adjustment and you'll get there. What we have demonstrated is just a small example of electromagnetism in action. This same principle, on a grander scale, is used in crane operation. Motors and levitating cranes, headphones, microphones, valves, and of course, superconducting electromagnets. Start small, think big. Imagine the possibilities. To wrap things up, in magnetism, objects attract or repel certain materials. Unlike most materials, electrons spin in the same direction within magnets. Opposite poles attract force. Identical poles repel force. Electromagnets are circuits with conductive coils. Electromagnets produce magnetic field because of Ampere's law. Direction of force can be determined by the right-hand rule. Tighter coils equals more strength. Electromagnets can be built at home. Electromagnetism is used in crane operation, headphone functions, and motors. We are ready to go out there and get our start in electromagnetism. Try a build for yourself. And please, share your results in our comment section. Thanks for watching What's What. This is Frédéric from the studio. Tuning out.